Everything we do as people on the land affects the water.
And we're fortunate to live in such a water-rich state.
Where does your water come from? Everyone will say, the tap. It's a combination of natural and artificial plumbing that brings that water to your tap.
You know, when I'm in the boundary waters and I have to pump the water through my little hand filter, I get back into civilization, and the first time I turn on that tap, it feels like magic. But then that wears off and you kind of get used to daily life again.
So let's talk about where the water in Maplewood comes from. It comes from Lake Itasca, flowing through Bemidji, flowing down past Aiken and St. Cloud, and then it's at Fridley, they pump it out of the Mississippi River, and they carry it in two huge pipes over to a chain of lakes in North Oaks.
We release it into Charlie Lake, and then Pleasant Lake, Sucker Lake, and Badness Lake.
And that chain of lakes then flows down past 694, right into the intersection of Highway 36 and Rice Street, right towards Lake McCarrons, and that's where the treatment plant is that treats all the water that St. Paul and some of the suburbs use for our drinking water.
And once we hit Vadnais, we have two gatehouses. They each have one 90-inch conduit flowing down to the plant.
Prior to modern-day drinking water technology, you could die if you had cholera, if it was a contaminated well.
On the average, 40 million gallons a day. Day after day, they're managing that kind of volume.
425,000 people drink the water that we treat here, Maplewood being one of our customers.
This is some of the raw water.
If you thought of river water, you wouldn't drink it right out of the river, but by the time we're done with it, you would, or you should.
What we're trying to do is remove the things from the water that we don't want to drink, bacteria, organic matter, color.
If we want to have high quality drinking water, we all need to be good stewards.
You can't pave over paradise and expect to have clean water. You can't throw your lawn clippings and your leaves into the street and not affect clean water.
Herbicides and pesticides, all of that ends up in some water somewhere.
Follow the water. Where does it go? It goes down into a pipe. That pipe goes out into a wetland or a pond, and that pond goes out into a bigger one, and that one goes out into a river, and the river is where we get our water that we drink from.
What happens in the Mississippi River, I think, is easy to feel like, oh, well, that's a few miles away. It doesn't have to do with me, but how all of our watersheds are ending up in there.
Minnesota is one of these unique places on the planet. We should be proud, though, that we have 60% of our water that's clean, because many other states don't even have that luxury. 40% of our watersheds don't meet clean water standards. That's really over on the western edge of our state and down into the south and central, where there's a lot more farming. We're in a unique spot. We're in this place where all of this valuable fresh water is. Even though we have this abundance of water, the right thing for us to do for our neighbors downstream is to conserve and protect.
It's just a really good reminder of how much work goes into making every glass of water that I get out of my tap. And so it's a good inspiring refresher for me to try and be cognizant of that at home and conserve the water where I can.
It's not somebody else's problem. It's not somebody else. It's ours, all of ours.
Be grateful for the people that designed and built that system, because when you turn on the tap, you have some of the safest, most available fresh water of anyone in the world. And we take it for granted. We think that it's just there because it always has been. It's an amazing infrastructure. Thank goodness for the people before us who built that amazing system. As soon as you are grateful, be concerned about what you're only using, what you need, and that you're taking care of someone else downstream.